Hey, Johnny.
Whoa, mister. You scared the bejeepers out of me.
Say, sport, would you like to learn about some chemistry?
Boy, would I. Whoa, where am I?
You're in the Department of Chemistry, Johnny. Behind these doors is where the chemistry happens.
That sounds swell, mister. Can I go in?
Hold on there, kiddo. First of all, we need to get you dressed for labs.
Okay, Johnny. Now the first rule of labs is that eye protection has gotta be worn.
Whoa.
Okay, Johnny. Now the second rule of labs is that lab coats have gotta be worn in case of chemical spills.
Jeepers.
Okay, and now the final rule is that, I'm sorry, Johnny, but there's no eating or drinking in labs.
Oh, man.
Okay, and now you're good to go.
So now we're in the lab. While in the lab, safety is our primary concern, so take a pair of these gloves.
Gee, thanks, mister. So what am I doing today?
Today, Johnny, you're doing the reaction of a tertiary alcohol with concentrated hydrochloric acid.
Whoa, swell! Where's my equipment?
Don't worry, Johnny. We've got a glamorous assistant who's bringing it to you right now.
Okay, Johnny, now you've got your equipment, it's time to read your method for the day's experiment. This is the protocol. It contains a list of the things you've got to do. Give it a quick read, and then we're good to go.
Mix T-butanol with cooled hydrochloric acid in a round-bottom flask. Separate the layers, and then discard the acid layer. The organic layer was then washed 3 times with water, sodium hydrogen carbonate, and then water again. At each step, the aqueous layer was run off and then discarded. The organic layer was then run off and dried over anhydrous magnesium sulfate. Finally, the distillation apparatus was set up and the oil purified by distillation.
Okay, we've got a while to wait while your oil distills. Would you like to learn some theory behind your experiment?
Sure thing, mister.
Okay then, well let's go to the classroom with our friendly neighborhood professor.
Professor! Professor! Show us the mechanism. Nice.
This is the SN1 mechanism. In the initial step, oxygen is protonated, water is lost, and a tertiary carbocation is formed. Now, we need some chlorine ions. These can attack from above or below to form a 50-50 racemic mix of products. However, these are identical, so this is our final product.
Okay, thanks. Now, Professor! 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 How about the other mechanism?
This is the SN2 mechanism. This time, the methoxide group attacks as the bromine is lost, forming a transition state. The bromine then leaves, giving our finished product. In today's experiment, the SN1 mechanism was used.
Back in the lab, and your distillation's complete. Here's your finished product.
Awesome! I can't wait to show my friends at school!
Slow down there, champ.
What is it, mister?
Don't forget the washing up.